हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल केमिस्ट्री विद एसके। इन टुडेज सेशन विल सी द अल्टरनेटिव फ्यूल्स। एज यू नो, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट पावर अल्कोहल एज अल्टरनेटिव फ्यूल। नाउ वी आर सेइंग बायोडीजल एज अल्टरनेटिव फ्यूल। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो व्हाट इज मीन बाय बायोडीजल। सो वी शुड नो द डेफिनेशन एज इट इज द मिक्सचर ऑफ मिथाइल एस्टर्स ऑफ लॉन्ग चेन कार्बोक्जिलिक एसिड्स। इट इज द मिक्सचर ऑफ मिथाइल एस्टर्स ऑफ लॉन्ग चेन कार्बोक्जिलिक एसिड्स विच आर ऑब्टेन बाय ट्रांसएस्टरिफिकेशन रिएक्शन। ट्रांसएस्टरिफिकेशन रिएक्शन, दिस वर्ड इज इंपॉर्टेंट। व्हाट इज ट्रांसएस्टरिफिकेशन? वन एस्टर इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू अनदर एस्टर, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रांसएस्टरिफिकेशन रिएक्शन ऑफ वेजिटेबल ऑयल एनिमल फैट्स with methyl alcohol using catalyst as sodium metal or sodium methoxide. It means sodium metal or sodium methoxide can be used as catalyst. So you should know that transesterification process is nothing but conversion of one ester into another ester. So this is the transesterification process. It means here in this case we need to take some vegetable oils. Generally non-edible oils are to be taken. And mainly these jatropha plants or jatropha oil seeds are used widely. You may ask that why non-edible oils are used. The reason is if we are using edible oils, the cost of edible oil will increase and the biodiesel which will be produced by using that will also be costly. So to decrease the cost of biodiesel, we need to take non-edible oils, and that's why this is the jatropha. You might have seen it in your fields also, that such type of plant is there and which is having such type of fruits. So there will be oil seeds. When it becomes dry, there will be oil seeds and it can produce some oil. So generally these oils, generally these jatropha plants are planted in very simple soil, or we can say in hilly areas also. It requires minimum water. Now we'll see the preparation of biodiesel, how biodiesel is prepared. So as we have mentioned, it is a transesterification reaction in which we are taking vegetable oil or non-edible oil, and that is to be treated with methanol by using sodium or sodium methoxide as catalyst. Then there is a formation of biodiesel. This reaction is very easy to remember, that is CH2COR1, CHCO2COR2, CH2COR3. It means these are the various alkyl groups and this is nothing but oil. So this is generally non-edible oil or vegetable oil. It is reacting with methanol, that is methyl alcohol, in presence of sodium methoxide. So what reaction happens, how reaction occurs? There is a breaking of this bond. CH3OH bonds are broken. There will be breaking of bond from this. Okay, the bond will be broken from this and the bond will be broken from this. So OH will join to this and CH3 will join to this group. So in the product side, it will become as this CH2CH2 here, CH2CH2, and this OH groups are joined to this 3OH group. So it becomes OH, OH and here OH here. So it becomes glycerol. Okay, in this way there is formation of glycerol. And what is remaining? R1COO, and here this is the CH3 group. R2COO and this is CH3 group. So there is a mixture of R1COO, CH3, that is these are the various esters again. And these esters, or this mixture of such type of esters, is nothing but biodiesel. So in this way biodiesel is prepared or biodiesel is formed. So we need to see what are the advantages of biodiesel. The advantages of biodiesel are it is very cheap as compared to the diesel because it is prepared from non-edible oil, or we can say waste oils can be used. It has high C10 number value. You might know about the octane number of petrol and C10 number of diesel. So high C10 number of diesel, it means it has high efficiency or high mileage. The C10 number value is ranging from 46 to 54. Its calorific value is also very high, that is around 40 kilojoules per gram. It means in case of power alcohol and petrol, if you have compared, there was a problem of lower calorific value of ethanol, right? But in case of biodiesel, the calorific value is also very high, so there is no problem about the power. It is a renewable fuel and it is environment friendly, eco-friendly it is, because it can be synthesized from non-edible oils, and such type of jatropha-like plants or jatropha-like oil seeds can be planted, and it can be a renewable source of energy, we can say, or fuel. Another thing is, as it contains oxygen atoms, therefore that oxygen will help for complete combustion. You know that due to incomplete combustion, many times there is a problem of pollution, we can say. Carbon monoxide like pollutants are released into atmosphere, but if you are using such type of fuels, then more quantity of oxygen or more elements of oxygen are present in their formulae. So this will be helping for complete combustion. It means these are minimizing the pollution. It has more lubricity, so it flows faster. Why it is mentioned? Because you might know that in case of petrol engine, the knocking or the cracking noise and vibrations which are coming, that are taking place due to sudden combustion or fast combustion. While in case of diesel engine, these are taking place due to delayed combustion. It means that the knocking is harmful. Knocking is not beneficial in case of petrol engine as well as in case of diesel engine. So if there is a continuous or proper flow of this diesel, biodiesel, into the engine, then there will be minimum knocking or better efficiency. It reduces our dependence on foreign countries for the petroleum, and we can save some foreign currency. So these are some of the advantages of biodiesel. Now we'll see some limitations or disadvantages of biodiesel. There are very few disadvantages. If you see, it causes problem in fuel flow line. So it should not be used in cold regions. It may have dissolving action on rubber hoses and gaskets. Another problem is, it strongly adheres on the metals and it becomes gummy. So these are some of the drawbacks or disadvantages of biodiesel. So guys, keep subscribed to our channel for getting updates for latest videos. Thank you.